Welcome back to Mac Break Studio. I'm Mark. I'm here with Steve in our beautiful new little location we've been shooting in. And today, Steve's going to talk to us about one of our great plugins.
Actually, it's not one of our plugins.
It's somebody else's plugin.
Well, it's funny because I did a video, I recorded a video at the Final Cut Pro Creative User Group 2 years ago on plugins.
Yes.
That thing has had almost 190,000 views.
Wow.
And so people are obviously interested in plugins. Yes. So I thought, well, in that vein, why don't we show some plugins? And there's a lot of them out there.
There are.
And one particular plugin company, iIndustrialEffects, run by Peter Wiggins at FCP.co. He's got a full-time editor. I don't even have time where he has time
it's
to actually
amazing.
Make these plugins.
Yeah, and run the FCP.co site.
Yeah, I'm sure he's,
busy man.
Busy. So busy man. I'm going to show one of his plugins that I actually like quite a bit. It's called a XEffects Glass Slideshow. So if you ever need to do like a slideshow, you can see some beautiful glassy effects. Let me show you an example. So here's a shot of a turtle that my friend Abba Shapiro took. And then you see a nice glassy effect with a nice glassy transition. And it's just really, really elegant looking
it
slideshow.
It is, I agree.
Okay, so that's where we're going. So let's take a look at the start place. Okay, so there's a couple things about...
So this is just your two clips of the timeline.
Just two photos, two stills, okay? Mm-hmm. I should point out that the plugin exists in like three places in Final Cut Pro.
This is installed through FX Factory.
That's right. You have to install through FX Factory, but in Final Cut Pro, there's three principal items that you apply to create this. You apply an effect, a transition, and a title.
So you have to go to those separate browsers.
Right. So under effects, I'll scroll down here. There it is. There's the slideshow portion of the actual creates the move. There's this transition component. This allows you to do the glassy transitions from one to the other. And then under titles and generators, you have the actual glassy effects that are you place as titles over the top.
Okay.
Including titles. So there's some titles as well. So there's quite
there's
a bit
a
here.
Lot going on.
All right. So now we know where everything is. Let's look at how you set this up. The first thing you want to do is you're going to want to change the scale of these clips, make them a little bigger. Because remember, when you're using these effects, they move and you can go beyond the edge and the edge will start showing. So what you're going to want to do...
Scale them up.
Yeah, you're going to have to scale them up a bit. So I'm going to select these and under transform, scale. Actually, you'll notice it's already set for 120, but now it's at 100. But I set these at about 120.
Okay.
Just a little bit.
Obviously, you're working with high resolution photos that have more resolution than your project.
Right. The other thing that Peter recommends is that you turn these into compound clips. So you're working with a container that contains them rather than the clips themselves.
Okay.
So I'm going to just Option G and compound clip that one. Select that one. Option G, compound clip that one. So I have these two compound clips that have been scaled inside at 120%. Okay, now let's apply the moves. So I'm going to move left, drag that there, and do a move right. By the way, it's 1080 and 4K versions. So move right. So now if I play this, turtle moves left, sponge moves right. Now if you want to change the speed, you have this
very
little
slow.
Right, it is a very slow, but you need to understand that to go left, it's negative numbers, to go right, it's positive. So if you want to speed it up, you're gonna go negative in this direction.
I see.
Right? So now it's faster. And so you can keep cranking these up to make it faster and faster, but keep in mind, you start seeing the edge.
You're gonna run out.
Yeah. So it's a trade-off between the scale and then how fast you want it. You're gonna have to play with it until you get it what you want. In fact, I'll speed this one up just a little bit there, just not too much. And there you go. So that works good for now. All right. So we're set up for the moves. Now let's go ahead and add the glassy effect. So over here to the browser, but I want to go ahead and close the inspector for now so you can see. I'm going to skim over some of these. You have the large strips, you have growing strips, medium strips, small strips. So I'm going to go ahead and use one of these strips here. I'm going to press X to set a range, that large strip there, and press Q And let's see how this looks. So I have this strip that grows across.
It crosses over. Nice.
Large strip grow. Let's do it. Let's also add a medium strip grow.
So you can add multiple title effects.
I'm adding now. I have a medium and a large strip glow. They're kind of like on top of each other. Yeah. So what I'm going to do is select this top one here. Go in the inspector. There's a lot of controls for these in the title inspector. Like, for example, that I can change the direction. I want that one to go left to right. So the bottoms
kind of cross each other.
So they cross each other.
Nice. See? Yeah. That's
right.
Great.
So they're crossing each other. And there's some other controls that you can change the edge width, the edge color, bright. You can play with the look of these. I'm not gonna do anything. I actually like the way these look out of the box, honestly. I think they look really, really elegant. So I can do the same here, but just to make this easy on myself, I'm gonna copy those and I'm gonna paste them over the next clip. That way I'm not having to, I could say, now just so I have some reverse polarity, I'll select this one. I'll do this one right to left, and this one left to right.
Yeah.
So now we don't have the exact same effect on both clips. And then it's a nice looking thing. But we need a transition here. In order to do that, you're gonna need a compound clip. So you're gonna select, now I'm gonna select that. Option G, compound clip out of that. Just like that. Option G, compound clip out of that. And now I have two compound clips. And I would like to put a transition there, but as you all well know, those use Final Cut, there's no handles, you know? And in the last episode I showed you the versatile range tool.
Yes.
So I'm in this range and delete. So I've just created some handles, right?
Yes.
Now I'm gonna go back to the transition browser. You'll see that there are a bunch of transitions in here. There's a large grow, and I kind of stick with the same, maybe that's kind of cool too. I'll just try that. So I'll throw that transition on there. And now I have a glassy transition that kind of ties these two together.
Very nice.
Isn't that nice?
Yeah. Yeah, it's clean, elegant, professional. Love it.
Yeah. So there's one other thing I might want to do. You can go further with this. That's what's really great. You keep stacking things. Like, for example, if I go back to XEffects, I can continue adding additional options on top. So let's go down here. So I can put more titles even on top of this. So I'm stacking even more on top.
Wow.
See?
Yeah.
And you can get really crazy.
Cool. And it can go running right across the transition.
Across the transition. And this is where I think the titles come in that are really great. So I got these titles. So put in here. I'm gonna drop that in there. I'm gonna split that title. And so I have this title now that comes on. Notice it animates on, and I have on-screen controls. I can put that where I want. Go ahead and type this in, select this out to say turtle. That's what he is, and go to the next one, and Saint Croix. All right, so I have a title now that comes in, and I can move it where I want. There's some options in the title inspector. I can change the direction, right, left. I can change the color, the color scheme. I can go in and change things like the line color.
Sure.
So I have all this control of the title.
And right now it's not being affected by those glass things, but if you put it inside the compound clip, then it would be.
Now, Peter on it, I think FX Factory has a demo tutorial where they put them inside the compound clip and they time it with the glass. I didn't want to do that. I just wanted to put the title on top. Point is, you can put them wherever you want. So I got turtle, and I could then copy this over here and make a, so here's my, and then, oh, and then I can just go in here and change this to sponge.
SpongeBob.
SpongeBob, I like it. All right, and good. So we got SpongeBob coming in. Of course, now I want to move him over a little bit. And so there. So now, look, you can see it's pretty, within a few minutes, I can create a pretty elegant slideshow with titles.
Yeah, and it's interesting because with some of these plugins, there's more involved than just drop it on, but you end up with something that's more customized and much better looking than something that just you drop it on and you're done. So right. it takes a little bit of work with the compound clips and going into the different browsers, yeah. but you can really create something very beautiful without any keyframing at all, and not knowing any sort of motion graphics.
Well, that's what's great, is there are no keyframes. You just move it, and it's very, very intuitive. The thing that, if you're new, you're going to have to get used to this idea of compound clipping.
Yes.
There's a lot of compound clipping. Yes.
And it's throwing, every time you create a compound clip, it's creating a copy in the browser, which will be confusing for some people because right. what are all these things doing there? But you can just kind of ignore them because you're just working in the timeline.
You could, although you'll notice I made a smart collection of just all my compound clips. And you can see that I have quite a few of them in there.
Very so good. There you go. Interesting. Very interesting. Great plug-in, Peter. Great job. And thanks for showing us how to do that. I hope you guys enjoyed that. See you next time here on Mac Break Studio.